Hi everyone, I hope you're having a great day. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to replace the famous Hollywood sign with your own custom text. I provided a template so you can follow along. A link to this template is provided in the description below. Once you open it, you will see a photo of the Hollywood sign, the same photo without the sign, and the folder that includes the support panels that hold the sign in place. I included three different sizes that will fit characters with different widths. I also provided the link to a font that matches closely to the one used for the Hollywood sign. Follow the link in the description and download it. I also provided a profiled metal texture pattern that we're going to use later in the video, so be sure to download that as well. To begin, pick the type tool from the toolbar and open the list of fonts. Click the load button on the top right and open the font you downloaded. Make its size 300 pixels. Don't forget to click the color box and pick white as the font color. Click on your document, type out your favorite text, drag your text layer to the top of the layer stack, and double click on it. Open the character panel and scale the text horizontally by 120%. Press the check mark at the top to apply the change. In the Layers tab, make the Hill layer visible and active. Reduce its opacity anywhere between 50 to 70%. Click the text layer to make it active and drag it over the Hollywood sign, so that the bottom of your first character is aligned with the bottom of the first character of the Hollywood sign. Next, we're going to make all the other letters aligned with those of the original Hollywood sign. Double click the text layer to highlight all your text. So to raise or lower a character, drag your cursor over that character, and in the character window, in the baseline shift field, enter a positive value if you need to move the letter up, or a negative value to move it down, until the bottom of each letter is aligned with the Hollywood character behind it. Do this for each character you want to raise or lower. If your text is long, some letters won't have any original characters backing them up, so just be creative with those. Next, with the text layer still selected, shift-click the panel's folder to select it as well, and press Command plus G or Control plus G on Windows to place them into a folder. Expand the folder, then right-click and choose Convert to Smart Objects. Make the panel's folder visible and active. Since the first character of my text is of medium width, I'll click on the medium layer to make it active. I'll drag that panel to my first character. The width of any panel should be slightly narrower than the character it's going behind. To adjust the frame size, press Command Option T or Alt Control T on Windows to open the Transform tool. Go to a corner and drag it in or out. The upper edge of the panel should align with the top of the character or just slightly below it, and the bottom stroke should preferably align with the bottom edge of the letter. To make a copy of the frame for your next character, press Alt or Option and drag it to the character it's going behind. Make another copy for your next character that has a medium width and drag the copy over that character. I will make the white panel active and move it behind the letter W. Make more copies of that panel for the other characters that have medium widths. And I will make the narrow panel active and move it behind the exclamation mark. Once finished with this step, collapse the panel's folder. Now it's time to add some effect to simulate how the original sign looks in real life. Go to Filter, Blur and Blur. The next effect is Drop Shadow, so click the Layer Style menu and choose Drop Shadow. Set it like that. Next, we're going to apply the profiled metal texture. Go to File and open the pattern. Once opened, go to Image and resize it to 25 by 25 pixels. Now go to Edit, Define, New Pattern. Then close the file. Go back to the main document and add the pattern overlay using the Layer Style menu. Click to open the pattern presets and pick the last one we just added. Make sure the opacity is set to 50% and click OK. The next effect is Outer Glow. Set the color to black, blend mode multiply, opacity 50%, spread 10 and size 3. Click OK. The last effect is Inner Glow. Now, since the panels that support the sign are held to the ground, the bottom parts need to be hidden behind the stones and shrubbery to complement that realistic look we're going for. To do that, add a layer mask to the panels folder. Reset the foreground and background colors to default black and white. Then pick the brush tool. Start brushing over some parts of the panels that you think should be hidden behind the stones or in the ground. The same process applies to the characters of the sign as well. Next, since the original Hollywood sign is angled to the perspective from which the photo was taken, we need to make our own sign aligned with that perspective. To do so, first click this folder to make it active. Then press Command Option T to bring up the Transform tool, right-click and choose Distort. Go to the top left corner and drag the corner inwards until it matches the angle of the H in Hollywood. Go to the top right corner and repeat the same to align your text to the perspective of the original sign. To commit the change, press Enter or Return or click the check mark at the top. Lastly, we'll cast a shadow of our new sign onto the hell. Hide the panel's folder for now and Control or Command click the smart object of your sign to make a selection with shape. create a layer below your text layer, then press Alt-Delete to fill the current selection with black. Navigate to the beginning of your text and using the Marquee tool, make a selection around the first word. Press Command plus Option plus T to bring up the Transform tool, then right click and choose Distort. Go to the top left corner and drag it down and over. Do the same thing on the left side to simulate the angle of the shadow that's being cast onto the stones and the bushes on the hill. Click the check mark at the top to commit the change. Press Ctrl or Command plus D to deselect. They follow the same steps for the other words as well. Currently the shadow looks too clean and intrusive, so go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, set it to 3 pixels. Again, go to Filter, Distort, Zigzag. The style is out from center, the amount is 70, and the ridges is 10. Bring down the opacity of this shadow layer anywhere between 50 to 70%. And hide the panels folder. And drag the shadow layer below it. Now that we have our text positioned on the hill, make the hill layer active again and increase its opacity back to 100. That is it for this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful. If you got questions, leave a comment below and make sure to stick around for more videos like this coming soon. Catch you in the next one. Peace.